Well, it's always a pleasure to see our next guest, and I know I look forward every year to her yearly horoscope to find out what's coming up in the new year for me and all
Absolutely.
My friends and my wife.
And if you want to know about your past, your present, and your future, and
a little bit,
maybe more than you want to know about yourself, all you have to do is pick up her book. It is called You and Your Future. Georgia Nichols, how are you?
Hi, Georgia.
Great. Thank you very much.
I'm just
delighted to be here.
Well, you brought the mighty Amazon to its knees, is what we were talking about before.
Yes.
I thought for some reason you had written a book before, but
no,
this is your first.
I've been writing, but all my columns, incidentally, take about 5 books a year. In other words, if you add them all
up.
But no, this is finally, the book.
Now tell us about how the book is organized. It's all
the
signs.
Sure, thank you. Yes, what it is it's the 12 signs, so it's an in-depth look at each sign. And then it also not only describes a sign, but then goes into the sign as an employer, an employee, a parent, a child, love, of course.
Yes.
And then I have a section at the end of each one on how to be a happier Taurus, how to be a happier Pisces, how to be a happier whatever. Well, and I think everybody should read all of those.
Well, and that's a really interesting aspect to it, because I think people sometimes think astrology is action on you, and you have no real say in what's happening in your fate, or no real influence, I guess.
Oh, no. I totally believe people have huge choices. In other words, you're male, you're female. Mm-hmm. So I mean, you're going to go with that.
Thank you for getting that right.
Yeah, you're going to go with that. That's what I mean. Just means, do you still have choice? Yes.
Yeah.
But she's the one in the heels. Gorgeous heels, might I add. Okay.
Well, thank you.
So from that point of view, we have some sort of if you could call it destiny factors, but we have huge choice. And incidentally, to continue back, if I may, it's got a 40-year timeline for each sign.
40 years.
Yeah.
The book is over 600 pages. And it's got a timeline to go into the future to 2025. But, hey, I could say anything about your future, right? Like, who knows? So, just so that you can believe me, I go into your past from 1985 up. And so if you read that, you go, hey, I did, get a divorce. So I did burn the house down. Oh. So,
now you said burn the house down. You said there's going to be a lot of fire in 2011.
We were on fire yesterday.
Yes.
And I also saw, I saw that. That was for real?
That was for real.
But we were protected.
It's
with
a special effects thing.
A new thing for special effects. I read about that in some book lately. Okay, yes, what it is Uranus. This year, Uranus is the planet of unpredictability and explosions and earthquakes, volcanoes, that sort of thing. And it's going into Aries. And the last time it was in Aries was 1928 to 1935. So it hasn't been in Aries for a long time. Incidentally, that was a time when our economy took a dive.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah. And I might as well also say the previous time when it was in Aries, combining with Neptune and Pisces, which is also happening this year, was the potato famine. So I think some things are going to be tight, but I have, on the other hand, Jupiter.
Is this why birds are falling from the sky?
Yeah, that's right.
I think actually people who are solid are going to get more solid, and people who are shaky better try to
figure
out
how to solidify that.
Yeah, I think things are a little bit going that way. But with Uranus and Aries, we're definitely heading into a time of fire hazards. Mm-hmm. Much more fire hazards. I went out and bought a fire extinguisher. But I've never done that
and
before.
And this goes across all signs and society and for the world.
It's for the world, yeah. So it's an unusual time where everything to do with fire is very unpredictable. And just today, as I was walking into the studio, I looked down at the Vancouver Sun. Oh, I'm in the province. Looked down into the sun, and there it said they're putting $800,000 more into their fire whatever.
Yeah.
I think
okay, can we talk?
Fire.
Can we talk about Taurus just for a
little
minute?
Oh, yes, Taurus. Actually, good news for Taurus.
Who's a Taurus,
well,
exactly?
Well, I am a Taurus,
because
Michael.
Jupiter, the planet of wealth and its good fortune and luck and whatnot, is going into Taurus in June. It's going to stay there for the rest of the year, and it hasn't been there since, I think around 2000, 2001. So this is a good time for Tauruses to increase their confidence, not that I think you need that, become more poised, and again, not that you need that, but good fortune. And so I'd say definitely in the next 2 years, Tauruses are going to make more money. Without question.
I like the sounds of that.
Interesting.
Without question.
And Pisceans? A friend of mine wanted me to ask about Pisces.
A friend, right. Pisces also are going to be making more money because they have had this good fortune that Taurus is coming into. They've just had it, so now it's going into their money section. So I see that the two of you in the next 18 months are coming into more money. Who produces this show?
Yes.
We like the sounds of that.
But seriously, you will.
Now, what does it mean when Mercury is in retrograde? Because people hear that all the time. They blame bad things on it. But what does it actually mean?
It isn't totally bad, but it's a bit of a drag. Mercury rules everything that goes forward. So it rules all ground transportation and conversation, words, ideas, the mail, courier services, stuff like that. Three times a year, Mercury appears to go backwards. It doesn't. Let's say that here's Mercury and I'm always going forward. I'm always going forward. I'm always going forward. But from your point of view, it doesn't look like I'm going one direction, one direction, one, right?
Yeah.
So when it gives the illusion of going backwards, then everything it rules on planet Earth gets like glitched. So it's a very bad time to buy cars, computers, and stuff like that. And sure enough, we have silly, goofy errors. We're late, we're at the wrong white spot. Right. Or the wrong Starbucks, something like that.
Right. That sounds like personal experience in there, Georgia, for some reason. I was supposed to meet someone. But it's such an interesting guide. I mean, when you look at it, right, and you read it as a map, as a guide, as possibilities, as things that you can push and things you should hold back on, it becomes really fascinating reading, and especially
like,
when you go into
I hate to think, and it's true, this book is going to be buried in the astrology section, but it really isn't an astrology book. It's more of a guide. It's more of a self-help book. It's more of a reference book. And the only thing about it astrologically is that it zeroes it into the 12 signs. Yeah. That's all.
What about the end of the world? What about 2012 and Nostradamus? And
don't go into debt. You're going to be around in 2013.
Don't blow it all. Don't make mistakes. The Mayans had it wrong.
Don't you think they're always saying that every 8 or 10 years the world is going to end?
Right.
But it's the Mayan prophecy, Jordan. Come on, we gotta go. What is it that sort of intrigued you with astrology when you first started? What was it that brought you into it?
You know, that's a really good question. I don't know, but I do know this. I grew up in a real small town in Manitoba, and I used to lie on the floor in the living room, and I found out about astrology in the newspapers, right? And nobody I knew was into it. My mom and dad didn't talk about it. The schools, church, nothing. But I saw it as hidden knowledge. I thought it was esoteric, and I was always attracted to it. And I can think back now, when I was 12, I still remember the signs of all my friends and people.
Right.
So I was into it all by myself.
Really interesting.
Yes, and I've always been into it. And I see it as, actually, it was taught in Oxford at one time. All the great mathematicians were astrologers. We see it in a light way, partly because of what I do, as media astrology.
Yeah.
But it's actually quite a serious study, and it's all based on mathematics.
Yeah.
Well, Georgia, thank you so much, and congratulations on the success of the book already. You can go to Georgia's website
to
find out all the information. If you want to pick up You and Your Future by Georgia Nichols, you can go to Amazon and try not to crash it.
Pick it up, and like Georgia said, read through the past, and it will make you read the future much more closely in this book. It's fascinating to watch.
Thank you, Georgia.
Thanks a lot.
Georgia, thank you. We're going to take a break.